Simon & Schuster Audio presents No Longer Radical, Understanding Mastectomies and Choosing the Breast Cancer Care That's Right for You by Rachel F. Brem and Christy B. Teal. Read by Jane Oppenheimer, with notes read by the authors.
For my magnificent family, who fill my life with passion, inspiration, and love, and for everyone involved with the Brem Foundation, you make the world a better place.
For Ashley, Nick, Ellie, and of course, Dave Teal.
Chapter 1. Are mastectomies right for you? Everyone knows someone who has had breast cancer. And no wonder, 1 in 8 American women are diagnosed in their lifetime. If that sounds terribly high, it is. In 2020, for the first time, breast cancer became the most common cancer in the world. As lifespans have increased and a range of factors from diet to decreased childbearing to exposure to environmental contaminants have shifted, breast cancer has emerged as an all-too-common part of women's lives and an all-too-common cause of their deaths. Fortunately, the odds of survival today are dramatically better than they were in the recent past. Major advances in genetic treatments, hormone therapy, and chemotherapy all give doctors, patients, and loved ones reason to be hopeful. 40% fewer women die of breast cancer now than 2 decades ago. Although it has received less attention, another advance is at least as revolutionary: the shift in how we think about and perform mastectomies. They are safer and more effective than ever before, and reconstructive surgical techniques have advanced so rapidly that those who opt for breast reconstruction often marvel at how natural their new breasts look and feel. What's more, women at high risk for cancer no longer have to endure the soul-crushing anxiety of hoping breast cancer doesn't happen. Instead, they can intervene with preventive mastectomies. If they have had cancer in one breast, they need not live in dread of getting cancer in the other one. If they're BRCA positive or have multiple first-degree family members with a history of breast cancer, they can preemptively remove their breasts. Instead of wishing, they can take action. Instead of hoping desperately to stay ahead of a disease we still don't fully understand, they can kick it out and bar the door. Preventive mastectomies have become so popular that in recent years, 3 times as many women under age 45 who are at increased risk of breast cancer have chosen to remove their healthy breasts. And as with so much in medicine, an ounce of prevention is worth a whole lot of cure. Advances in surgery now make it possible to have breast reconstruction during the same operation as mastectomies, so women can leave the operating room with new breasts of whatever size and shape they prefer, and if the surgery was prophylactic, with little to no risk of getting cancer. The relief women experience is often profound. Studies show that when women have all their options presented clearly by a sympathetic doctor, they give mastectomies serious consideration, whether for treating breast cancer or preventing it. Yet the current trend in the medical community is to recommend that women attempt to save their natural breasts at all costs. Again and again, our patients tell us how they were discouraged by their doctors from choosing mastectomies. The opposition was so strong that they felt they were not able to assess whether mastectomies were right for them or not. Women diagnosed with breast cancer at a young age are increasingly opting for contralateral prophylactic mastectomies, that is, removing the other healthy breast, if their doctor leaves the option open. Doctors have a huge effect on their patients' choices and outcomes. Women who discuss the option of mastectomies with a female surgeon are 3 times more likely to choose it than those who discuss it with a male surgeon. In the past 50 years, Our understanding and treatment of breast cancer has radically changed. We now know about close to 80 mutations associated with an increased risk for breast cancer. In addition to the well-known BRCA1, BRCA1, and BRCA2, BRCA2 mutations, more will undoubtedly be discovered. But knowing how we got to this point is also really important to understanding how much progress we've made. In the 1970s, the best medical scientists considered breast cancer to be a viral infection. Suspecting that some cancers had a genetic component, Dr. Mary Claire King relentlessly pursued her hunch for the next 24 years. Dr. King's identification of the BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutations in the early 1990s was a revolutionary breakthrough in understanding genetic risks for breast cancer. There is no reason now that any woman with a mutation in BRCA1 or BRCA2 should ever die from breast or ovarian cancer, she said. It's her view that identifying a woman as a carrier of a genetic mutation only after she develops cancer is a failure of cancer prevention. More exciting innovations are constantly becoming available. We continue to improve methods for identifying those who are at an increased risk for breast cancer, as well as options to prevent breast cancer altogether. Mastectomies today are safe and highly effective in essentially eliminating the risk of getting breast cancer. That's an enormous relief to many women who are at a markedly increased risk of breast cancer. Of course, preventive mastectomies are not the right choice for every woman. Most women diagnosed with breast cancer can safely keep their breasts with minimal risk of recurrences or new cancers. But if you're at increased risk for developing breast cancer, or if mastectomy is right for you when breast cancer is diagnosed, or even if you're diagnosed with breast cancer that can be treated by a lumpectomy, we wrote this book to help educate you about your choices so you can consider your options in an informed way and begin to open the conversation with your physician, family, and loved ones. No matter where they live or who their doctor is, women deserve to know that they may have access to a procedure that has brought relief, freedom, and even joy to both of us personally. As female doctors who have had mastectomies ourselves, we want to share with you the same critical information we give our patients every day. For decades, we've sat down with women to talk them through the facts, figures, and data they need to make the best decision for themselves. Too often, we're the first to tell them this option is even available. We want to emphasize that the decision is a very personal one. The purpose of this book is to arm women with the information they need to make the right decision for themselves, a balanced decision based on all the latest medical and scientific updates. Not everyone at increased risk for breast cancer should undergo preventive mastectomies. However, nobody should be pushed or frightened into thinking that they should save their breasts at all costs. As is the case with nearly all decisions, there are pros and cons to both. After learning all the facts, the majority of our patients do not elect to do preventive mastectomies, but about 40% of them do, and they're very happy with the results. Both of us, Rachel Brem, a breast radiologist, and Christy Teal, a breast surgeon, have been working in the trenches against breast cancer our entire careers. We've suffered devastating personal losses to breast cancer, and we're intimate with the uncertainties our readers face. We too struggled to decide, how high is our risk of breast cancer? Were we willing to live in suspense, anxious about every scan or test result? Would we actually go so far as to remove our breasts to eliminate cancer from our lives? We each made different choices, as did the patients and the stories we'll share. Because we've both been grateful every day that we had mastectomies ourselves, we're in an ideal position, as individuals and as breast cancer doctors, to tell you exactly what to expect. We will walk you through the dozens of personal decisions you will be asked to make and help you figure out how to make them. It's essential to have information you can rely on when the choices are so critical and often made at a time of unfathomable stress. The decision will affect the rest of your life. Preventive mastectomies can be one of the most positive, empowering ways for a woman to take control of her life by boldly and actively reducing her odds of getting breast cancer. And mastectomy to treat breast cancer can absolutely be the right decision for some women, even when conservative treatment where the breast could be saved.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.